four $100,000 Delaware Standard Bred Breeders Fund of Finals went behind the gate recently, and it's time to check out the winners from these rich three-year-old events. To kick it off, let's bring in the first state bred trotting fillies in action. As we saw last year's two-year-old champion, Disco Soleil, visit Victory Lane again.
They go into the far turn. Command today in Sierra's Choice. About two or three lengths, Disco Soleil begins to close the gap. Three quarters, 129 and one-fifth. They're midway on the final turn. Sierra's Choice, command today, Disco Soleil will be soon second as they come toward the top of the stretch. Sierra's Choice has the lead. Disco Soleil forced to wait now as they come off the turn. Sierra's Choice, command today. Disco Soleil angles toward the passing lane, coming through the stretch. Dark Duchess on the far outside. They come toward the wire. Three on the wire. Disco Soleil's going to get up. Disco Soleil in front. Sierra's Choice was second, 159 and one.
Disco Soleil came up the passing lane to win in a career best of 159 and one for trainer Carlo Policino. Delaware Governor John Carney was on hand to present the trophy to the winning connections. The daughter of CR Commando is now 3-for-3 in 2019 for owner, breeder, and driver Rod Allen.
Rod, tell me how the race unfolded for you. I actually wasn't expecting that trip, were you?
No, but going for that kind of money, you know everybody's going to be gunning out of the gate to try to get position. So there was some confusion. One horse made a break, and then a lot of guys are leaving. She's all charged up. We got it done, but it was tough.
Tell me about the end there. Even me watching it, and I have no connection with the horse, I was a bit like, oh my gosh, is she going to do it? What were your feelings?
I didn't know if she would get there before the wire came, because there's not a lot of room to work with there. But she was running in a little bit, so it was easier to use the passing lane than normal. Didn't have to coax her down in there, so once she's seen clearance and daylight, then she's game and she's got a lot of class, and she trotted enough to get it done, but it was close.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned that, because I think a lot of people don't realize most horses are used to kind of running out, like, you know, people pulling the right lines, driver pulling the right lines. They're not used to a driver pulling the left line to go up the passing lane, but thankfully, because she was sort of on that line, it was good for you tonight.
Yeah, sometimes it works out to your benefit.
Tell me about how she has matured from a two-year-old to a three-year-old.
She got a little aggressive. I think we would have been better off if we'd have stayed racing instead of giving her a break, because she just kind of figuring things out, and then we give her a break and gave her some time off, and then coming back was more difficult than what I anticipated. And then we had to take a lot of equipment off. Like tonight, we had a straight overcheck bit as opposed to a Crit Davis bit on her, so I couldn't double her up. Her head's way down too low. I know Kim wanted in, and I was trying to let him in, but there's no way I can double him up, you know, to let him in so I can make a move, and it gets him trapped out there, and I feel bad for that, but it's racing.
Right, right. Yep. And as she gets older, she might, you know, be a little more level-headed and controllable, yeah. And, you know, that comes with maturity, right?
Yeah, the breed is kind of the breed, and you know, we breed them to race, and then we get upset when they want to race. Too hard, right?
Right, right, right.
And then we try to correct them.
Yeah. Right. Well, congratulations. Another big final. So I appreciate being on the show. Thank you.
Thank you, Heather.
Moving on to the male division for the three-year-old trotters, it was another champion from last season, Embrace the Grind, taking home the trophy in his DSBF final.
They go into the far turn. Embrace the Grind by a length and a half. Getting Ziggy when it races outside of Rich and Royal. Two more lengths, Justice Striking, Go Jet him alongside, and Dr. Grinch off the rail, 126 and 4. Coming over toward the top of the stretch, Embrace the Grind begins to pull away. It's a three-length lead, back in the second, clearly is Rich and Royal, soon to be third. Justice Striking, they're at the top of the stretch. Embrace the Grind with about a five-length lead. In second, Rich and Royal. Justice Striking down the inside, coming toward the wire. All alone is Embrace the Grind. Embrace the Grind wins it. Rich and Royal, followed by Justice Striking, 157 and 4.
Embrace the Grind led the whole mile and won easily by four lengths in 157 and 4. The son of Keystone Activator, bred by Tyler and Lee Raymer, is owned and trained by Bobby Glassmeyer and driven to victory by John Roberts.
Yeah, I'm not a fortune teller. However, I probably could have predicted that race, even the trip. So why don't you tell me, how did it unfold for you?
I guess you're a better fortune teller than I am, because I was really unsure about how the trip was going to work out. I thought I had the best horse, but I knew there'd be a cavalry charge coming from the outside, so we had to protect position just a little bit. And it so worked out that Kimmy was able to leave around most of the rest of them, and it kind of settled things down pretty quickly. So it worked out really well.
When you made that quarter pole move, like, I thought you were the winner. What were you thinking?
I was hoping that that was the right move to make, and yeah, that was where I wanted to be.
Tell me about the rest of the trip as far as how strong he felt, because, man, he looked good, so good.
He was very strong tonight. Bobby really had him up on his toes tonight, and up the backside, he was just dragging me right around there. When Corey came first over and started to speak to his horse, it made my horse just trot right off. I really didn't have to ask him at all. He did it all on his own.
How about the difference between him being a freshman to now he's a sophomore? Has he gotten bigger or anything like that?
He's about the same size. He's a little bit more mature. He doesn't look at so many things now. He's starting to pay attention to his job, and he's doing it pretty easy. I'm pretty happy with the way he came back this year.
Very cool. We'll see you at Harrington.
Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Now, let's bring in those talented pacing fillies as we watch In and Out Again score in her sophomore final at Dover Downs.
They go into the turn, and the duel continues up front between In and Out Again and Vista Mista. 124 and 3/5. They come over toward the top of the stretch that way. Vista Mista, In and Out Again, getting closer. Roddy's at it again. Three lanes going to fool you, trying to get by. Biggie's second shot, the rat at the top of the stretch. In and Out Again's got the lead now, turning around by almost two. Down the inside, Roddy's at it again. They come through the stretch. It's In and Out Again, In and Out Again, with Roddy's at it again, coming toward the wire. In and Out Again in front. Roddy's at it again, and Biggie's second shot, 154 and 2.
In and Out Again led the way from gate to wire and battled right down to the last step in an impressive 154 and 2 effort. And Delaware's Secretary of Agriculture, Michael Skuse, was there to present the trophy. The daughter of Roddy's Bags Again was bred by Kay Skinner and trained by Kay's son, Jason Skinner, who owns the filly with his father, Tim.
You must be so proud of her. That was an absolutely amazing race.
Yeah, it's like the first time we've actually raised one and actually got to the winner's circle. That's pretty nice.
What were you thinking during the mile? I mean, were you like, wow, is she going to pull this off, or were you really confident?
I was pretty nervous. The Montreux run, I kind of got scared because I wanted her in the two hole sitting behind Montreux. So I was a little nervous.
And she really battled hard during the mile. It was so impressive.
Yeah, I think it's the first time she's ever been on the front end, so I was pretty happy with her effort. Very nice.
Your mom bred her. You've raised her and everything. Tell me about the progress from the time that you started taking her out there to show her what she's supposed to be doing for a living until now, because I didn't hear a lot about her last year.
Me and my mom bred her. We raised her mother, and from day one, she was very natural, good gaited filly. Did everything right, just had kind of a little bit of bad attitude, didn't really wanna do it. You know, she's kind of come into herself the last 3 weeks, I mean, more than her whole life. Like a two, she win, but it wasn't impressive. Like, not like she does it now. It's a lot better.
Well, she came into herself at the right time.
Yeah, she did.
Not only did you have a win in there, but you had a third,
yep,
right?
Yep.
Okay, so tell me about who was third and the relationship that she has with In and Out Again.
That was Biggie's second shot. She's also a homebred. Me and Joan and Ellie Dauphin bred her, and couldn't be more thrilled with her. You know, it's exciting. She had a sister, she was just okay. This one's way better than her sister. And these two have been together from day one. They jog together, they eat together, they do everything together. I mean, they like being together. They get upset when you take one away from the other one.
Well, I'm sure they're looking forward to being together at Harrington, right?
Yes, so, yes, they are.
Big things to come, hopefully, on the half mile.
I hope so.
Thanks, Jason.
You're welcome.
Finally, we'll top off the winners of the DSBF finals with Goldberg, who took home the winner's share in the Pacing Colts division.
They're into the far turn. Goldberg. Goldberg chillaxing away. Number to count, 123 and 3/5. that looks like 26-3 on the third quarter. Coming over toward the top of the stretch, Goldberg. Chillaxing away, settles in behind Goldberg. Number to count, trying to stay third. Mike, they come to the top of the stretch, and it'll be Goldberg coming off the turn with a two-length lead. Goldberg sprinting for the wire. Chillaxing away, not gaining. They come toward the wire, and it'll be Goldberg. Goldberg went all the way. Chillaxing away, and Air Spender. 151-2.
Goldberg was another winner, setting off all the fractions on the way to a big victory. Executive Director of the Delaware Harness Racing Commission, Mark Davis, presented the trophy. The son of Mr. Wiggles, who crossed the wire in a sizzling 151-2, is trained by Brenda Teague and is bred, owned, and driven by Brenda's nephew, Montrell Teague.
Montrell, I've seen you happy after a lot of races, but man, you are ecstatic. Like, just tell me about the race.
Well, you see me so happy just because I own this one. Like, I'm usually getting 5%, now I'm getting 50. So that's why I'm so happy. And last year he caught a virus, didn't know how good he was gonna come back, but I'm glad that he came back and he actually made it to the Delaware Stakes and won the final.
Your aunt, Brenda, is the trainer on this one too.
Yep, she was traveling with him everywhere last year, so she's the best one for the job.
Yeah, a lot of smiles in the winner's circle. It was great. Now, I know you usually have a plan going into a race, and a lot of times plans do change. What about tonight? What was the plan, and did it go the way you thought?
It kind of did. Having the one horse scratch kind of changed everything because you didn't know how much you had to leave. But once I got to the front, I tried to back it down as much as I could because I seen Timmy was getting in 3-hole instead of 2-hole, and it worked out way better for me. So I could steal some fractions on him and roll home after the half.
He looked so strong. I mean, just even going past the finish line, he looked like he was ready to go around again. I mean, he's a good-looking, big, strong horse.
Yeah, he was way stronger. I had to rush him back a little bit because he caught the virus, turned him out. Didn't want to try to do it last year because I didn't want him ruining him. But we caught back up, rushed him back, and he's getting better every start.
Now, is it true that you are putting him in the little brown jug this year?
Of course.
Oh. You're like, Heather, come on now.
That's my number one race right there.
That is so incredible. Okay, well, it's something to look forward to. I know it's still early. It's only April, but still, I mean, the jug will be here before we know it.
Exactly. Even if I don't have one in it, I'm going.
All right. Awesome. Thank you and congratulations, Montrell.
Appreciate it.
Congratulations to the first round winners of the Delaware Standard Bred Breeders Fund Finals. Yes, I said first round, and that's because we'll see these Pacers and Trotters in more stakes action at Harrington Raceway starting on June 10th.